July 3rd will be at 6:30 p.m. No morning mass on the fourth. Visit the parish website, www.stboniface-univer.org, for more detailed information about parish events and happenings. Now, please take a moment and say hello to the people around you. Our opening hymn today is number 191, Creator Spirit, by whose aid, number 191. Please turn to number 191, stand, and join us in singing our opening hymn.
Birthday of the church. Our prayer is today, come Holy Spirit, dwell into our hearts, into our lives, into our homes, into our families, and nourish us with the gifts of your life and spirit. Before we begin this fast, with God's mind our sins, we ask God for pardon and forgiveness. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God in mercy on us forgive us our sins and bring us to a lasting life.
Egypt in the districts of Libya and Mascarene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs. Yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues of the mighty acts of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And in his head, heaven he grew. Dulcis Benedicite Dominum. In laeve acquies, in estuve tempies, in plenum solatium.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the evening of the first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven. Whose sins you retain are retained."
the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning once again.
Good morning, Father.
I'd like us to begin our reflection today with hymn number 444, the three verses that we are coming from you. Everything that we have gone through for the ministry, for the people, for the parishes. So it's always with emotion that I come, a little bit of Jewish emotion, that I come to this feast day. The other thing that is always also playing around for me in my own mind is that in Uganda, around the first week of June, we have a huge celebration, the celebration of the Uganda Martyrs. And people from all around the world descend onto Uganda. Because the 22 martyrs that were killed at this place called Mbongo. This year I was watching on YouTube and I was saying, I wish I would have been there, you know. The celebration, many people from across the world, over 2 million people, 2 million people died. The whole country is on standstill. Pilgrims are walking, for many of you who know where Uganda is situated, from Tanzania, Zambia. All these countries, and they walk on foot, to Mbongo, the shrine. So it's a huge celebration. And all of us, wherever we are, in the diaspora, we call ourselves, we all want to feel that we are always back home. Because that's the celebration that is full of spirit, globally. When I come to, on a more serious note, to celebrate, and I've done this now for the last 13 years, Pentecost, I have it on a much stronger kind of way. I struggle with whether it is sure that the church of today should celebrate Pentecost. Is it true that the church of today should celebrate Pentecost?
That's why some of that question goes, are we even glorious for the church of Pentecost, for the beginning of the church? Are we today, the church in America, the church in our parish, are we a church of Pentecost? Pentecost for me always signifies the following things. A church that is so bad. A church that is bold. A church that is forward-looking. A church that is confident. A church that proclaims and speaks the gospel with its life. A church that serves others. A church that is willing to suffer with others. A church that is present in our families, in our homes. A church that is thriving and is alive. Is this the church that we have here today in our world? A church that is full of energy and presence. A church that makes the presence of Jesus known. A church that is welcoming. A church that is tolerant of others. A church that forgives. A church that reconciles. Are we in this kind of church today? On a day that is not like this, when you enter into any Catholic church, do you feel it's a church of spirit and life? What must we do to make the church of today a church of Pentecost? I feel that's the challenge that we all have. Am I a priest of Pentecost? A priest who is full of life, who proclaims the gospel boldly, in my journey to have been assigned. We have heard today that in the church of Pentecost, the church was on fire. It was on fire for its mission to proclaim the gospel with its lives. And the other Christians, the apostles, were resolute and ready to risk anything to speak and act like Jesus in the world. Do you and I do so today? That is when we will be truly a church of Pentecost. Or else, we're just celebrating something of the past. Are we a church of Pentecost today? It was a church that united others. This message that all people from all creeds, all nations are welcome. This was the church of the early beginnings. How does our parish community, our communities in the world, in various parts of our country, and our church here in America, model this kind of community of the early church? The Holy Spirit is with us for sure. All of us have been given the gift of the Spirit by our baptism, by our confirmation. We have been given this gift of the Spirit. The question is, do we keep the gifts to ourselves? Such that sometimes we don't fire up the church. We don't make the church a church of Pentecost. And so the challenge is ours today. To make our church today, the church in which we live today in our parish, a church of Pentecost. Full of life, a church full of energy, a church full of boldness that proclaims the gospel with our life, wherever we are, whatever we do. St. Paul challenged the community of Corinth in today's second reading. They existed a little bit after the church of Pentecost, the early church, the beginning of the church, and they had problems in that community of Corinth. The second reading that said that there were people who had various gifts and talents, courageous. But they used those gifts and talents to foster divisions and separations amongst the people. Each one of them was saying, I am for Paul, I am for Apollos, I am for this one. And it caused a kind of division and separateness in the church then. Do you have a gift? Do you use it for something much more than yourself? Do you share your giftedness with others? In your own parish community, in order to make it a community of Pentecost. Each one of us, therefore, as we gather to celebrate this feast, is challenged in one way or another to make your community in the church of Pentecost. Proclaim the gospel in your life. Give them yourself. Make the gospel values known by the way you live your life. In that way, our church will continue to be connected to the past Pentecost. Many of you who are listening to me know it is a challenge. It is a challenge to be church, to be a person who believes in the gospel, proclaim it in your life. Sometimes we shy away. So we need to pray for the gift of the Holy Spirit, the gift of courage, in our families, in our lives, we may proclaim the gift of the Holy Spirit by proclaiming the gospel in the way we live our lives. Let us not give it to fear, but be bold and receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, proclaim it with the right. May the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us now stand, and we will profess our faith, for we believe in one God, the
Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven.
And by the cross of the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man.
For our sake he was crucified and Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven, and seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let's lift up to the Lord some of our prayers and intentions.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For renewal of the gifts of the Spirit in our lives, that we may recognize and put into practice all the gifts that we have been given, so that the body of Christ may be strong in serving the reign of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a renewed sense of mission, that the Spirit will inspire us in confronting the watered-down values of society and in building a society of justice and peace.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a spirit of forgiveness, that God would break the bonds of resentment and vengeance that hold our hearts, and free us to forgive as we have been forgiven by God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a spirit of justice in the world, that those who are poor, who have experienced abuse, who are refugees, may know freedom, relief from oppression, and their dignity as daughters and sons of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a spirit of hope, that all those who are overwhelmed by life may find new reasons to choose life this day, and be gifted with a new vision of tomorrow. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, that they may rest in eternal peace, especially Antoinette Brasso. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We ask for these needs and intentions to Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns in the name of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Preparation of gifts in the number 452, the Spirit of Tongues, number 452. Thank you.
Let us now pray that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
And Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all of his holy church.
Lord, may the Spirit you promised lead us to all truth and reveal to us the full meaning of this sacrifice. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Father, O God and ever-living God, we will always and everywhere give you thanks. Today you sent the Holy Spirit on those marked out to be your children by sharing the life of your only Son. And so you brought the Paschal mystery to its completion. Today we celebrate the great beginning of your church, when the Holy Spirit made known to all peoples the one true God and created the many languages of man. One voice obeys one face. The joy of the resurrection renews the whole world, while the choirs of heaven sing forever to your glory.
Oh, God, in the heart.
glory of what indeed the fountain of life of holiness. Let your spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord has given up death, and then we accepted, he took bread in his hands and broke it. He gave it to his disciples and friends, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ready, the cup of giving thanks and praise, he gave it to his friends and disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Make us grow in love together, Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, or the clergy. Remember our family, brothers and sisters, family members, and today to remember this Mass, all who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all, we pray. And the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Apostles, the Saints, all who have done your will for the ages, may we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. By the help of your mercy, we may be free from sin, safe from all distress, to await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, see the apostles beside you, mine beside you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of the church. Grant us the peace, the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
So the Lord will be
holy. And with your spirit.
We extend to one another the sign of peace.
Peace to you.
Behold, Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold, he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Gather the wheat.
prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael.
Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him who humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thus in the power of Satan, and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruins of souls.
Let us stand. Father, may the food we receive in the Eucharist help our eternal redemption. Keep within us the vigor of your Spirit. Protect the gifts you have given in your church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And now shall bow our heads and pray for God's blessing into the cause of hope for all. Amen. This day, the Father of Light has enlightened the minds of the disciples by the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. May he bless you and give you the gifts of the Spirit forever. Amen. May the fire which hovered over the disciples as tongues of flames burn out all evil from your hearts and make them glow with pure light. Amen. God inspired speech in different tongues. Proclaim one faith. May he strengthen your faith and fulfill your promise, your hope, to see him face to face. Amen. May Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
For the choir, we just find a hymn to wish us some appreciation for what they have done. As we give up our gifts, then we really become the Church of Pentecost. As we do exactly what the choir and Jeremy and many of you do, we really become the Church as the Church of Pentecost. And may the Spirit of God be with us as we do so.
Closing hymn today is number 377, The Spirit Sends Us Forth. Number 377.